Lady's Kitchen. We're not doing a recipe today because we're going on a field trip. We're going to Wallace Station, which is in Versailles, Kentucky. I know you call it Versailles, but we call it Versailles. And we're going to a place that is Wallace Station. It is a place that is a little bit famous around here because it's been visited by Guy Fieri of Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives. And he actually said that one of the hamburgers there was one of the five favorite hamburgers that he had eaten. We did not get that last time we went, and you might want to actually look at our last visit that we took you along, but we'll try to get that today, make up for it. We found other things on the menu we wanted last time, but we'll show you an assortment of things. It's just a sandwich shop. It's really a fun place to be, and we decided we wanted a day out of the kitchen, and so we're taking you along. There's Carter and Chelsea. It's my grandson and my daughter. And they're in the back seat, so we're going to move around to the front and show you some of the land here while it's summery. There's some horses over there at the side. This is a horse farm. There are several horse farms along here. And it's a beautiful day, very sunny. And it's pretty hot too, but not as humid as it has been. And right here is Wallace Station, so it's not going to be long until we're inside and we will have a nice lunch. This is the front of Wallace Station, just right behind me across the road, and we're going to have our lunch here, and we wanted to let you see what it looks like outside. Carter and Chelsea are over there waiting for us, so we'll see you inside. You can see from the sign on the wall here that Guy Fieri was here. So that makes this place a little bit famous around here. We have the best burger ever. Ordered a Diet Coke, so I'm gonna get my eyes here. And plenty of Coke, and of course we come back, and you can kind of see the people working on the food there, and here putting plates together. Over here is the counter, and on the back side you can see some panini makers or grills. And that's where the sandwiches are made. And there's a coffee station on back a little bit. And then let's go here. This is the coffee station. And then here we have cookies and muffins, donuts, scones. I'm going to pick some of these up as we get ready to leave. There are some condiments there. Informal. There aren't that many people here right now. It's a fun place to come.
Alright, I've got my sandwich here. I've got the Cubano sandwich, which is a roast pork with ham and Swiss cheese. And it's on a whole wheat bun. It's grilled like a panini. Some chips and a pickle spear and some potato salad on the side. Now, let me take that. What did you get, Eddie?
What I have here is the Big Brown, which is the hamburger that Guy Fieri from Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives said was one of his five most favorite hamburgers. It has a nice thick bun on top, and you'll see that there is a sauce here that's a cheddar mornay sauce. It's on top, and it's also on the bottom. And in between, we have ham, folded over a few times. That's not country ham, we call it city ham around here. There's a slice of tomato, and here is the burger, and it's really well done, and for me that's perfect. Some of you might not want it that well done, but I forgot to even ask to make mine really well done, but they did anyway. Here we have some crisp bacon on the bottom. It's very crispy, which I like that too. And my side that automatically came with it was some ridged potato chips, and I have a dill pickle spear, and then I ask for another side, which is watermelon. Enjoy that in the summer. And actually, their air conditioning is down today, and they've got fans going, but it's pleasant in here. It's probably in the 80s, but it's nice. We're enjoying ourselves, and we're moving on to Chelsea's plate. Here's what Chelsea's got.
I got the protein power salad, and it has so many things in it, I probably can't remember it all, but it has baby lettuces and turkey, ham, red onion, tomato, some sprouts. That's about all I can remember in there. There was a vinaigrette that came on the side, and I also have a pickle spear here, which actually came with Carter's meal, and he graciously gave it to me. And then I just have a Coke Zero to drink, so we'll see how good it is. And Carter, what did you get?
I got some grilled cheese and some chips, and I got some homemade.
Does it look good?
Mm-hmm.
It looks good. So we'll be back after we have had our lunch, and we'll tell you if it was good or not. And I have my eye on the cabinet, which has cookies, and I may go home with a few cookies. Pick up some cookies here. Notice that we have a lot of varieties. Could I get a ginger jam and also a corn cookie? And could you tell me, is that made out of corn flakes or something?
It's made from like cornmeal.
Oh, that'd be good. I would like one of the chocolate walnut cookies. White chocolate.
Okay. That's it. $7.
Okay. Rick and I were not able to finish our lunches, so we just took what was left over to the counter, and they packaged them up for us. They had a sign on the wall that said, if you can't finish your lunch, just bring it to the front and we'll take care of it. So we'll be taking those home with us. And since we were at the front, I was so tempted by the cookies that here's what I came out with. And these are wrapped individually. This is called a corn cookie, and it's made from cornmeal. Maybe it has flour in it too. I'll have to experiment with that if I do anything about the corn cookie, but it looks good. And then here is a ginger cookie. And then this one is a white chocolate chip walnut cookie. And you probably think I eat tons of sweets. I don't really. What I will do with these is take them home and freeze them just like they are. And then sometime when I just feel like a little something sweet at night, usually Rick does too. So I'll get one of these out of the freezer and come to room temperature or more than that in the microwave, divide in half, and we'll have our little treat, but without overeating. So we really watch the calories and don't go overboard, but we like nice stuff. And the food here is just great. It's better for us to buy a single cookie like this and split it than to make 2 dozen cookies, which we do occasionally for YouTube. But then we're left with cookies and we usually give them away. So this serves our purpose just fine. We've had a wonderful time. We're going to be here just a little bit longer, and we'll show you some scenery on the way home.
You heard of Little Madison?
Yeah, it's all commercial. And we got one Lego set.
Little Madison?
Uh-huh.
You know about those?
And it came with 2 glow-in-the-dark pieces. One was a skeleton
horse. You're talking about monsters.
The monsters. What you can make robots with. Little
monsters.
But they actually do. They have motors in them, gears, and they program them.
Oh, that's great. I have a Lego thing where you build cars, they go down the slide, and that's a Lego.
He doesn't have anything like that. It's probably for older kids, right?
Stop!
We've all got Cokes to go, so we're going to get in the car and head home. And I hope you enjoyed this little trip with us. We had a really good lunch. Couldn't eat near all of it, but we'll have part of it for supper tonight. We're on our way home from Wallace Station. This is very close to Wallace Station. We just left, and you can see that there are some beautiful farms around here. Mostly horse farms, and you may see an occasional horse. I think we have some coming up. I know we're going by very fast, but you might see a little bit of Kentucky from this video. Going straight ahead again, so you can see a little bit from either side. This is a nice time in Kentucky for scenery. A lot of times we'll take our road trips in the winter, and all the trees will be bare of leaves, and there will be sleet and snow and things like that. But the pretty time to get out and do something is summer, and this is what you'll see in summer in Kentucky.